This module is on scenario of teacher education in modern and contemporary India. Objectives of this module are introduction to development of teacher education in modern and contemporary India, teaching methods adopted in modern and contemporary India, and aims of teacher education in modern and contemporary India. Teacher education in modern India can be divided into two periods, pre-independence, that is British period, and post-independence period. In this module, we will be discussing about the teacher education in modern and contemporary India. So now let us first examine teacher education system in pre-independent India. In pre-independent India, first institutions for teacher training was started by Danish missionaries under the inspiring leadership of Zeigenberg and his colleagues at Trachtenberg in 1716. This was followed by establishment of a normal training school for the primary or elementary grades by William Carey at Serampore, West Bengal in 1802. In 1834, Lord Macaulay came to India as a law member of the Council of Government. As per Lord Macaulay's minutes on Indian education, literature meant English literature and not Sanskrit or Arabic or Persian literature. He emphasized that medium of instruction should be English. Earlier to this, a survey was conducted by the then British government of India to know the real position of education in India. This survey was conducted in three places, that is Madras, Bombay and Bengal only. And the conclusion was that each village had a primary school. Corporal punishment was observed, students followed timetable, condition of teachers was bad, and teachers were ill-educated and ill-paid. Lord Bentinck, the Governor General of India, appointed Adam in 1835 to survey the state of education in Bihar and Bengal. On the basis of this survey, Adam suggested some measures for improving education system. One of the measures proposed by Adam was that the teachers of indigenous schools should be trained. He proposed converting vernacular department of English schools into normal schools for training of teachers of indigenous schools. He suggested that these teachers should be required to study in these schools for 3 months in a year for 4 successive years. Now let's see what happened later on. This was followed by the Woods Dispatch of 1854. Let's see what happened in that dispatch. The Woods Dispatch recommended the establishment of teacher training schools in each of the provinces. It furthermore stated that there should be training schools for teachers of engineering, medicine and law. The qualified teachers should be given better pay scales, and the dispatch further emphasized the provision of scholarships to the teachers during their training period. The Woods Dispatch of 1854 was followed by Indian Education Commission in the year 1882. Lord Ripon, the then Governor General of India, appointed the first Indian Education Commission on February 3, 1882, under the chairmanship of Sir William Hunter. Sir William Hunter was a member of the Executive Council of Viceroy. That is why this commission is also popularly known as Hunter Commission. It was considered as second milestone of Indian education for training of secondary class teachers. At that time, there were only 2 training colleges, that is Government Normal School, Madras, and this school was established in the year 1856, and the second one was Lahore Training College, Lahore, that was established in 1881. These schools admitted both graduates and non-graduates. Indian Education Commission gave its valuable suggestions in the field of education in various ways. It recommended an examination in the teaching be instituted, success in which should thereafter be a condition of permanent employment of a teacher in any secondary school, government or aided. It also suggested that separate training courses for graduate and undergraduate teachers should be introduced. You will be surprised to know that as a result of these recommendations of the Hunter Commission, 6 training colleges and 50 training schools came into existence by the end of 19th century. The commission highlighted on establishment of a number of normal schools under a divisional inspector for the training of secondary teachers throughout the country. It also recommended that an examination in the principal and practices of teaching be instituted, and only successful candidates should be employed as teachers in any secondary school. In 1889, Lord Curzon was appointed Governor General of India. At this time, the wave of nationalism was flowing fast. A further step in teachers' training was taken in 1904 with the passage of Government of India Resolution. Some social reformers were demanding national education at that time. They thought that only national education could safeguard the culture, civilization, literature and language. The Government of India Resolution 1904 on education policy declared that if the teaching in secondary school is to be raised to a higher level, if the pupils are to be cured of the tendency to rely upon the learning notes and textbooks by heart, if, in other words, European knowledge is to be diffused by the methods proper to it, then it is most necessary that the teachers should themselves be trained in the art of teaching. The following principles were laid down to improve the teacher training in the country. Number one, importance should be given to the equipment of training colleges for secondary teachers. Number two, practicing schools should be attached to each college to correlate theory with practice of teaching. Number three, there should be 1 year course leading to university degree or diploma for graduates. These courses should include both theoretical background along with the practical bias. For undergraduates, there should be 2 year course. Number five, training colleges should be linked with the schools so that a teacher may not neglect the methods learnt in the college when he or she accepts teaching as a profession. These recommendations had a far-reaching effect. The number of training institutions increased and separate courses were provided for graduates as well as undergraduates. In 1912, it was declared eventually that under the modern system of education, no teacher will be allowed to teach without a certificate of having qualified to do so. In 1917, the Government of India appointed a commission to study the report on the problems of Calcutta University following the Universities Act of 1904. The commission was appointed under the presidency of M.E. Sadler, who was the Vice Chancellor of the University of Leeds at that time. This commission is also called Calcutta University Commission, and it is also known after M.E. Sadler, and it is known as Sadler Commission. In 1919, the Sadler Commission presented its report and emphasized the role of university in the professional training of secondary school teachers and educational researchers. It suggested that the training programs should not only prepare the trainee for education system, but also it should prepare a good administrator. So at that time, they highlighted the importance of training in administration also. It further suggested 4 significant measures for improving the training of secondary school teachers. So these were institution of master's course in education. Number 2 was introduction of education as a subject for study, both at the BA and intermediate level. And number 3 was improvement in the facilities of training institutions. And number 4 was setting up of an experimental high school to be attached to a training college. As a result of these recommendations, many training colleges for secondary school teachers were started. And in 1929, Hartog Committee, it also worked further in this direction. It extended the work initiated by Sadler Commission and gave valuable recommendations and suggested conferences and refresher courses for those teachers who were already in service in order to raise the standard of school teachers. As a result, refresher courses for teachers began to be organized. Education departments were established in some universities and research degree in education was started. Teachers' training institutions also started equipping and also improving their laboratories and libraries. Working on the recommendations of the Sadler Commission, education faculty was set up in 13 universities out of 18. Amazing, it's. And the Lady Irwin College was set up in New Delhi. And the Andhra University that started a new degree, which was called the B.Ed. In 1932. Bombay launched a postgraduate degree in M.Ed. in 1936. By all these measures, teachers' training went on being benefited by improvements. This was followed by Wardha Education Conference that was convened by Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi in 1937. He propounded a new system of education, popularly known as basic education system. Gandhiji felt that the need of making teacher training was that it should be more practical, and also the teacher training should be more functional. He offered craft-centered and productive education for children, and that was correlated with the life situations for holistic development. With this, he emphasized that the teacher training should be practical based and also relevant to the needs of the pupil and the community. In 1938, a basic training college was set up at Allahabad, and there was another college that was Vidya Mandir Training College, and it was popularly known as Vidya Mandir Training School. This was started in the year 1938 and it was in Wardha. Keeping in view the reforms suggested by all these reports, the British government had begun to understand the seriousness of the situation in the area of education. Ultimately, in the mid of 1940s, the government of India realized that it could no longer be indifferent to the problem of education of Indian people, and there was a need of bringing about radical reforms in all aspects of Indian education. So Sir John Sargent, the education advisor to the government of India, was advised to prepare a comprehensive scheme of education for educational reforms in India. For this purpose, the government formed a committee of inquiry with 22 members. The report of the committee was submitted to the Central Advisory Board of Education in 1944. The board accepted it and recommended its enforcement. The scheme was known as Sargent Scheme of Education, as it was prepared by John Sargent. The Sargent report emphasized on teacher training programs and also on the need of refresher courses and for trained as well as untrained teachers to be organized at different intervals. It further recommended that the scale of salary of teachers should be increased in order to have able and efficient teachers. Thus, we can now summarize that in pre-independent India, various committees which looked into the system of teacher education and training were instituted. Of them, Woods Dispatch, Government of India's Resolution of Education Policy of 1904, Hartog and the Sadler's Commission made substantive recommendations which hold good for the present time too. On the whole, we can also conclude that a number of recommendations by various committees and commissions were made during this period. However, the corresponding increase in training facilities was not adequate. Now, let us discuss the teacher education in the post-independent period in India. During the post-independent period, too, various commissions were appointed to look at the educational problems from time to time. The first such commission was Radhakrishnan Commission, which was appointed in 1948 by the Government of India. This commission is also known as University Education Commission. It was under the chairmanship of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. The commission submitted its report in 1949. The commission was mainly concerned with the university education, but it made recommendations for teachers' training also. Now, let us see what they are. These were, number one, teacher training colleges should be remodeled from time to time and more time should be given to practice teaching and weightage should be given to practical examination than theory. And number two was that in the training colleges, teachers should be recruited from those who possess sufficient teaching experience. And third recommendation was the theory courses should be flexible and adaptable to the local need and circumstances. So these were wonderful recommendations of Dr. Radhakrishnan Commission. With a view to improve teacher education in India, the commission put forward many more valuable suggestions. It recommended that the teacher educators must look at the whole course from a different angle. They must realize that the study of education at university level is something more than mere education, that theory and practice must go hand in hand, and each must support and throw light upon the other. That the unintelligent following of rule of thumb methods should be discarded, that not less than 50% of the staff should have had school teaching experience. that the courses in the theory of education must be flexible and adaptable to local circumstances. It also said that students must take the master's degree in education after some years of school experience, that the original work by the professors and lecturers in education should not suffer from isolation and lack of inter-university planning. After this, in 1952, the Government of India appointed the Secondary Education Commission. Now, this commission was under the chairmanship of Sri A.A. Mudaliar. The commission strongly recommended the improvement of working conditions in the training colleges. Valuable suggestions made by the commission were that there should be only two types of institutions for teacher training. Number one, for those who have taken the school leaving certificate or higher secondary leaving certificate, for whom period of training should be 2 years. And number two, for graduates for whom the training may for the present be one academic year, but extended as a long-term program of 2 years. In other words, there should be 2 years course for non-graduates and 1 year training course for graduates. In addition to this, it also recommended that the graduate training institutions should be recognized by and affiliated to the universities, which should grant the degree. Secondary grade training institutions should be under the control of a separate board appointed for the purpose. The pupil teachers should be trained in one or two extracurricular activities. The commission also stressed the importance of refresher courses, short-term intensive courses and specialized courses, workshops and conferences for in-service teachers. The training colleges should have, as a normal part of their work, arrange these activities. In addition to above recommendation, it also suggested that no fee should be charged in training colleges during the period of training. All the student teachers should be given suitable stipend by the state. The teachers who are already in service should get the same salary which they were getting. For master's degree in education, trained graduates who have normally done a minimum of 3 years of teaching should be admitted. In order to meet the shortage of women teachers, special part-time training courses should be provided. For the implementation of the multipurpose schools, now the concept of multipurpose schools was also coming on later on. It was felt that there is a need of trained, qualified and competent teachers. As a result, it was felt that there was a need for a planned program of teacher education. With this aim in view, under the National Council of Education Research and Training, or popularly known as NCRT, 4 regional colleges of education were established in 4 regions of India in 1963. These regional colleges were established at Ajmer, Bhopal, Bhubaneswar and Mysore. In recent past, we have got another college which you might be knowing, that is called, that is at Shillong, and that is popularly known as Northeastern Institute, Regional Institute of Education. It is catering to the needs of the 7 sister states, that is the Northeastern states of India. So, it's a newly established institute, and the characteristics of these teacher education institutions and programs have been design and development of integrated courses of 4-year duration in different areas, establishment of demonstration multipurpose schools to work in synergy with the regional institute of education to function as educational laboratories in teacher preparation, a fully professionalized academic schedule involving interaction with community during summer vacations available in the duration of 4 years of the teacher education program. And this would focus on the role of teachers as an agent of social change. In 1966, Education Commission under the chairmanship of Professor D.S. Kothari was appointed, and it pointed out that the major weakness in the existing system of professional education was a teacher preparation, and that was weakness in the teacher education and teacher training program. The commission made many recommendations which may be classified into following areas. Number one was a removal and isolation of teacher training from the main academic life, improving the quality of teachers' training program, expansion of teacher training facilities, making adequate provision for continuing professional education of all teachers, creating appropriate agencies for the maintenance of standards, both at the center and the state. Later on, in 1986, the new education policy, which is known as National Policy of Education, looked at the role of teacher and the expectations of teacher education in a holistic perspective. It mentioned that the government and the community should endeavor to create conditions which will help motivate and inspire teachers on constructive and creative lines. Teachers should have the freedom to innovate, to devise appropriate methods of communication and activities relevant to the needs and capabilities of students and the concerns of the community. It stressed that the teacher education is a continuous process and its pre-service and in-service components are inseparable. It further recommended that the new programs of teacher education were to emphasize continuing education and the need for teachers to prepare to meet the thrust that were visualized in the policy. As per the new education policy, the District Institute of Education and Training were to be established. These are popularly known as DIET, D-I-E-T. It was proposed that they should have capability to organize pre-service and in-service teacher training programs for elementary school teachers and for the personnel working in non-formal education. Further, it was stressed that as the DIETs get established, substandard institutions were to be phased out. It further stated that the selected secondary teacher training colleges were to be upgraded to complement the work of State Council of Educational Research and Training. And after this, there was also in 1995, in order to bring about desirable changes in the field of education, National Council for Teacher Education was set up as a statutory body. The objectives of this council are, number one, to achieve planned and coordinated development of teacher education system throughout the country. Number two, to regulate and maintain norms and standards in teacher education system. The first step for achieving quality standards was publication in 1998 of a document which you might be knowing, it's a well-known document that is called Curriculum Framework for Quality Teacher Education. This document highlighted the importance of information communication technology and value education in teacher education program. Thus, the post-independence period was characterized by major efforts that were being made to nurture and also to transform the teacher education and to enable it to meet the needs. At present, the system of teacher preparation has come under considerable pressure as a result of the expansion and growth of the school education through efforts to universalize elementary education. Major efforts have been made to adapt and update the teacher education curriculum to local needs to make it more context-based, responsive and dynamic to the needs of the society. The latest NCT regulations present a sea change. BEd program now is of 2 academic years duration. There is countrywide formulation of compatible curriculum with the enhanced time duration of the teacher education program. Each unit of DLET, BEd and MEd is now of 50 pupil teachers. There is a corresponding increase in the teacher education institutions and also the staff. And there is countrywide formulation of compatible curricula with the enhanced time duration, and this is well known to all of us. So students, from this discussion, we can conclude that the expansion of teacher education in modern and contemporary India took place in terms of quantitative as well as qualitative aspects. Various commissions and reports during this period emphasized on the quality of teachers in general and teacher educators in specific. And it was always a challenging task to make it effective and more practical to achieve perfect quality and make it relevant to the context of that time. So that was a big challenge. And I thank you very much. And I hope you enjoyed this learning. Thank you.